بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله الحمد لله وبه نستعين على أمور الدنيا والدين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه الأجمعين. Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, let us praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has given us this opportunity to be in this blessed gathering of knowledge. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, subhanallah al-azim. In Islam, a woman is an image of appreciation, consolation, comfort, great respect and love in every position that she holds. The Quran teaches us that Nabi Adam alayhi salatu wasalam and Hawa alayhi salatu ma were created from the same soul, both equally responsible and equally valid and equally guilty for the mistake that they did. As Muslims, we believe that all human beings are born in a pure state, men and women, and that we must strive to preserve this purity through iman as well as good intention and deeds. The theme of equality runs through other Islamic teachings too. An important verse in the Quran which reads, the men believers and the women believers are protecting friends one of another. They command good and forbid evil, and they observe prayers and give charity and obey Allah and His Messenger. And this verse shows us that men and women have equal responsibilities for observing Islamic teachings. In Islam, a woman is a completely independent personality. She is entitled to inherit in her position as a mother, as wife, as sister, and as daughter. The pagan society, Jahiliyyah period of pre-Islamic Arabia, had an irrational prejudice against their female children whom they used to bury alive. Rasulullah ﷺ was totally opposed to this practice, and through Islam he showed them that supporting their female children would act as a screen for them against the fire of hell. There is no doubt that Islam came to honor women, guard women, protect women from mankind, secure her rights and raise her status. Sayyidatina Maryam alayhi salatu ma was a person who was chosen and directed to exemplify Allah's mercy and message. She was a Muslimah whom we all can admire and learn from. Women are not small, superficial beings, but solid, spiritual, God-conscious and deserving of our appreciation. Maryam alayhi salam, the mother of Isa alayhi salam, is mentioned more than any other woman in the Holy Quran. She is the only woman mentioned by name in the Quran, and an entire surah is named Maryam after her. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states that Maryam alayhi salam is the greatest woman in all of creation. And it says in the Quran, O Maryam, surely Allah has chosen you and purified you and chosen you above the women of the world. Surah Maryam is the 19th chapter of the Quran. Like every surah of the Quran, it contains valuable gems and lessons. The opening story of Surah Maryam is about Nabi Zakaria alayhi salam and the miraculous birth of his son Yahya alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states that he has accepted Maryam as a result of her mother's vow, and that he made her grow in a good manner, meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made her conduct becoming, a mannerism delightful, and he, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, made her well-liked among people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also made her accompany the righteous people so that she learned righteousness, knowledge and religion. And Allah says in the Quran that he put her under the care of Zakaria, meaning to say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made Zakaria alayhi salam as her sponsor. Allah made Zakaria Maryam's guardian for her benefit, so that she would learn from his tremendous knowledge and righteous conduct. Here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is preparing Maryam alayhi salam for the difficulties that will come in her life, and orders her to establish a strong relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through ibadah. When the angel appeared to Maryam, she did not know that it was an angel. She thought it was an evil person who had come to harm her. And yet, In that time, she remembered Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and she was quoted in the Quran saying, indeed, I seek refuge, the most merciful, from you. So leave me if you should be fearing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the angel said, I am only the messenger of your Lord to give you news of a pure boy. In the eyes of Maryam alayhi salam, the angel in a form of a man was at first someone who had come to harass her. And yet, even in such a delicate situation, she reminded him of Allah's mercy. She mentions the mercy of Allah and not his punishment. Maryam alayhi salam was made pregnant by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is something that was difficult for her. She had never been with a man, nor was she married. This would bring unnecessary scrutiny and slander. Moreover, she was alone during the really difficult time of childbirth, and yet she did not for once question the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and she knows that Allah has decided, and no matter how difficult it looks, there will be goodness in it. Maryam alayhi salam had extreme pain, and that made her feel as if it would have been better for her to die. However, she did not question Allah's decree, which is Allah's taqdir, nor did she blame Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All she said was, it would have been better or easier if she had died before that. But she still persevered. Expected brothers and sisters in Islam, Muslims are forgiven for their thoughts. It is their actions for which they will be questioned. Despite the immense pain, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made things easy. She had a child, and Allah also provided her a flowing stream in the middle of the desert and dates from a date palm tree. There will be times of hardship, but Allah will bring ease. As He says in the Quran, إِنَّمَا الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked Maryam alayhi salatu wasalam to shake the date palm tree. Even 100 healthy male athletes will struggle to move a date tree. Imagine how difficult it must have been for a woman in labor, and yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked her to do it and she obeyed. Then miraculously Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought for her dates and provided for her a stream of water. Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, our actions are not really of much use. It is Allah who brings us the result. Our job is to do what He orders, even if we do not understand the wisdom. And if we obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in times of darkness, He will shine His light from places we never imagined. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends a clear reminder to us, women are spiritual beings too. Women are judged not on appearance alone, but on their taqwa, piety, consciousness and trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Maryam alayhi salam was looking for refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when Jibreel appeared to her with the news of a son. She received the message and acknowledged Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's taqdeer. Then she submitted only to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, trusting that the faith would be rewarded and not abandoned. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, and of His signs is that He created for you from yourselves mates that you may find tranquility in them, and He placed between you affection and mercy. Indeed, in that are signs of for a people who have thought. Surah Ar-Rum, verse 21. One of Allah's signs is that He has placed love and mercy between spouses. They love and show each other mercy, and nothing is more beloved to each other than the other. This is the case despite there having no relation between them previously and for no reason for them to be together. This is a sign of the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Throughout the seerah of Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we know that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam treated his wives the way they should be treated. They were gratified by His presence, tenderness, affection and the love that He provided to them. Khadija radiallahu ta'ala an was a successful businesswoman in her own capacity. And it was she who proposed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Even after their marriage, she maintained her business and even used her money to support the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his cause, especially during the period of isolation. During his initial experience in receiving the revelation, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was in a state of confusion. It was she who calmed him down, assured him, and brought him to meet Waraka, her cousin, who then explained to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that he is the last messenger. Khadijah radiallahu ta'ala and did all this not just out of love and nurturing care, but due to her wisdom, her ability to take control of the situation and to find solutions. And these were the values of hers that made her one of the most cherished individuals in the lives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The second incident, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam found himself consulted by Salama, his wife, during the incident after the signing of the Treaty of Hudaybiyah, when the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala and refused to follow his instruction out of protest for signing what they deemed to be an unfair treaty. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was in a state of confusion and he went back to his tent. And there he found the solution through Salama. He heeded her wise advice, and true enough, the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala and started following what he did. This was not a random piece of advice. It was important and calculated. Lastly, his wife Aisha radiallahu ta'ala and was one of the one wives that he spent his last days with. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in his last days passed away in the house of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala an. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala an was blessed with knowledge that she acquired from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. She is the narrator of more than 2,200 hadith, which today shape the Islamic legal traditions. She is one of the most compelling figures in the mainstream of Islamic intellectual history, and she helped the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in resolving many issues after the death of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And her nephew Urwa bin Zubair attested to her knowledge. Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala benefit us from this knowledge. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of those who would be able to put into practice what we listen. Wabillahi taufiq wal hidayah. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.